The Lord gave me a word this morning that I want to share with you all. For us to pray for clarity of God's will, clarity of God's direction for our lives, for the body of Christ. And the Holy Spirit will show me how we're at an hour where personal desires that don't line up with His plans and will for our life to be removed, because there's such spiritual deception increasing in the land that will move people away from the will of God for their lives. And so this morning, as we go before the Lord, dear Heavenly Father, we say good morning to you. Good morning, Holy Spirit. We give you all the praise, glory, and honor this morning as we're before you. Good morning, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Father, today I ask you to saturate our minds with your truth, so that we live our lives convinced, dear my Father, that every answer we need is found in your word and not out there in the world. It's found in your word, dear my Father, and not in people, places, and things, dear my Father. Dear my Father, we come before you this morning asking you to help us to continue to be what it is that you created us to be, to proclaim the good news of your love, that all who hear it may be brought to you, dear my Father. As we lift up Christ, dear my Father, may you draw men unto yourself. And so, Father, this morning we just thank you and praise you, hallelujah, that you reign over heaven and earth. And you desire that your children operate in the unity of the faith, the unity of the Spirit. And so we just thank you and praise you this morning, dear my Father, that we have clarity. Clarity of your will for our lives. Clarity of your will for our families. Clarity of your will for our assignments, dear my Father. Clarity as to what we're to do in this hour. As the world is evolving, the world is changing, and there's a spiritual evil and aggressiveness that's in the earth realm, dear my Father, and persecution that's coming, dear my Father. Prepare our hearts, dear my Father. Father, I pray that each and every one on this line this morning is rooted and grounded in your word, dear my Father. They understand what it means to trust you, dear my Father. Father, you are the God of our salvation, hope of all the ends of the earth. We pray that the world may know Jesus Christ as the Prince of Peace, as there is turmoil breaking out throughout the nations, as there are world disasters taking place throughout the nations. We pray that all who are estranged and without hope may be brought near to you, Father, in the blood of Jesus Christ. We pray that the church may be one in serving and proclaiming the good news of the gospel. You, dear my Father, we pray that we may be bold to speak the word while you stretch our hands, dear Heavenly Father, to touch those who need to be touched, dear Heavenly Father, as we understand that this life is about you and what you've called us to do and be and how you want us to represent you at this hour, dear Heavenly Father. Father, I thank you and praise you, dear Heavenly Father, for each and every individual online this morning, dear Heavenly Father. Understand what it means to be salt, to be your flavor in the earth realm, dear Heavenly Father. Father, we love you. We desire your will, your way, your order for our lives, dear Heavenly Father. Holy Spirit, give us direction today. Give us direction in this season. As things are rapidly changing, Father, I thank you and praise you, dear Heavenly Father. Not one is growing tired. Not one is falling away from the gospel of Jesus Christ. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive those who have trespassed us, against us. Father, and forgive us for any of our trespasses as we so desire to be in the center of your will for our lives, for our families, dear Heavenly Father, for our assignments, dear Heavenly Father, for our financial affairs, dear Heavenly Father. We thank you and praise you, dear Heavenly Father, for your direction. And so, Father, I just thank you and praise you, dear Heavenly Father, that your word is ever present. You're ever present in our lives. And your word never returns back to you void. And so, Father, I thank and praise you that prophetically you shall make each and every one of us, dear Heavenly Father. We are the head and not the tail. I thank and praise you, dear Heavenly Father, that we're above and not beneath. Father, I thank and praise you that each and every one of us hearken unto your voice, hearken unto your instructions this day, and observe to do your will this day, dear Heavenly Father, in this season, dear Heavenly Father. And so by the written word of God, which is the sure word of prophecy, I declare and decree that every individual on this line, every individual in this house, Abundant Harvest Lift, are the head and not the tail. You are rising, each and every one of you, to the pinnacle of God's purpose for your life and family. I declare that over your life. And that everything that God has for you is going to come to pass as you hearken, as each and every one of us hearken to his voice. Listen obediently to God's instructions for our lives. So we know in this day that we live in nations, many people have only known trouble, pain, and bad experiences. They have therefore concluded that this is God's will for them. And God shows us in his word that his heart towards us and his plans for us is to be above only, not beneath. And so as we enter into this, the close of summer and transitioning in seasons, Father, lead us, guide us, direct us, that we would exercise your word, exercise your plan, be led of the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, in prayer, hallelujah, according to your prophetic word, dear Heavenly Father, that has gone forth, dear Heavenly Father. I thank and praise you that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Father, I thank and praise you that each and every one of us, dear Heavenly Father, are prepared for the dynamics of warfare that we will face. And that we'll walk in a dimension of dominion to rule in our individual domains and rule together within this kingdom. And so, Father, I decree that every area of our lives are lined up with your word. And I call things forth by the power of your word. I thank and praise you, dear Heavenly Father, that you're establishing everything that you have for us in the spirit realm, dear Heavenly Father, right now, so that when warfare increases, dear Heavenly Father, we won't waver, we won't falter, we won't sway away, we won't tuck tail and run, but we'll stand strong in the power of the Lord. And so, Father, right now, I thank and praise you, dear my Father, that you're frustrating every wicked and evil plan and activity going on against our nation, ministries, families, individuals' lives. I decree that the word and will of God shall be fulfilled and accomplished in each and every one of our lives, that no evil shall befall us that would take us out. We will be everything that you created us to be, Lord. We are above only and not beneath. You have not created us to fail. As long as we trust in you, as long as we're doers of your word and not hearers only. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you and praise you, hallelujah, that you've given us everything that we need. Jesus told his disciples, I have been given all authority in heaven and on earth. And so, Father, I thank you that that same authority, hallelujah, has been handed down to us. He said, lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Father, we thank you that you are with us always. No matter what is transpiring in the earth realm, you're with us. We can count on you. You'll never leave us. You'll never forsake us. Father, I thank you and praise you, dear Heavenly Father, that you're leading and guiding each and every one of us, and not one of us will be deceived by the enemy, nor deceived by our desires, by our fleshly carnate desires that would be a distraction and take us out of your will, out of your destiny, and forfeit your blessing. Father, we exercise this day our kingdom authority, and we renounce all spirits of fear, the fear of man that brings a snare, self-pity, insecurity, and inferiority. Father, forgive us for not trusting in your provision or your timing and for failing to rest in your love. Father, I thank you and praise you, dear Father, that trust brings about rest. And today I declare that each and every one of us are trusting in the Lord our God. And we will not lean to our own understanding, but in all of our ways acknowledge him. We renounce all spirits of heaviness that brings about depression, ultimately mental illness, obsessive compulsive disorders, schizophrenia, suicide, and grief. We bind it in the name and by the blood of Jesus Christ. We renounce the spirits of unbelief, double-mindedness, that the cares of this world and all the things that would give an individual divided loyalties in their hearts and minds towards you and your assignment are abolished in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we renounce every seed that Satan has sown into our minds and our hearts that would cause divided loyalties and weakness in our spirit man, which would weaken our convictions towards Jesus Christ. We renounce this virus, this COVID-19, this Delta variant, that would cause such fear in the earth realm and divide and social divide. Father, I thank and praise you, hallelujah, that each and every one of us are trusting you in this hour, dear and Father, trusting you, dear and Father, with our lives, with our families, with our assignments, dear and Father, as we lean not to our own understanding, dear and Father. We ask you, dear and Father, to give us clarity, that we not be deceived again by our own selfish desires, but we would only be influenced by you, by the Holy Spirit. Lead us, guide us, give us clarity of direction. Father, I know that you love each and every one of your children, so we bind thoughts right now that would say they're sick, that there's such sickness that they can't function, that they won't make it. We cast those thoughts and those ideas down right now in Jesus' mighty name. We give you all the praise, glory, and honor. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you and praise you that this is a day that you've made, and we're rejoicing. And we thank you and praise you, dear my Father, that we're honored to be your sons and daughters. We're honored to represent you this day. We're honored, dear my Father, to be your salt, your flavor in the earth realm, dear my Father. We're honored to be a part of the body of Christ. We're honored, dear my Father, to be gifts. We're honored, dear my Father, to be members of this family of faith. And so, Father, I thank you that each and every individual online this morning is blessed and highly favored. I thank you and praise you, Heavenly Father, that the strategies of the enemy are bound and annihilated and cannot succeed in any of their lives in Jesus' mighty name. So, Father, I just thank you and praise you right now that your word is working for each and every one of us. I thank you and praise you, hallelujah, that everything is working out for our good and your glory. I thank and praise you, dear my Father, that our heart's desire is to be in the center of your will. Our heart's desire is to be doers of your word and not hearers only. Our heart's desire, dear my Father, is for every aspect of our life to be lined up with your will. Our family, our children, our children's children, hallelujah, our financial affairs, dear my Father. I thank you that they're lined up with your will, your way, your order, dear my Father, and not our selfish desires, dear my Father. And so we're lenders and not borrowers, dear my Father. I thank and praise you that we're givers and not takers, dear my Father. I thank and praise you, dear my Father, that we're your expression in the earth realm.